First up, we have 250 grams of pork and 250 grams of veal. In pounds, that's about a half pound of each meat. Here we have two small onions, which we'll be dicing very finely or shredding. Here we have fresh milk, whole milk, 7 ounces. We're here at 2 eggs. Here at 3 tablespoons of flour, wheat flour if you have it. All purpose is fine too. 1 teaspoon of freshly ground black pepper and 1 teaspoon of salt. That is literally all you need to make these delicious meatballs.
Blend the meats together. Let's add your dry ingredients. Lightly beat your egg. Pop it in. The onions were ground very fine in the blender. Let's add those. There is a lot of mixing. Looks good. Time to add milk. Just a little at a time, about 1 ounce at a time. And a little more. Did I mention the mixing? So I'm just testing here to see if it'll hold its form when I put it on the spatula. And it does. So I can add some more milk. I feel like the more I mix this, the lighter it gets. And it's holding its shape still. So I'm not going to use all the milk. I had about 2 ounces left over.
So just scoop it onto one. You can take away the excess around the edges. And you just scoop it under again from one spoon back to the other. And I like, as they do, an irregular shape. I'm going to put that into the oil, which is now heated. I'm not pushing down, I'm not doing anything to them. I'm letting them rest where they are.
I also made a creamed cabbage, another traditional dish. It's basically cabbage, shredded cabbage in a bechamel sauce. We'll cover sauces one of these days.
I'm just going to go. 3 seems like a good amount. Lovely. I obviously baked or boiled some potatoes, small potatoes, also traditional. And last night I decided to pickle my own cucumber. Sounds bad. But it's a couple of different vinegar, sugar, salt, and mustard seed. It's a lovely accompaniment to this dish. Oh, and I love the flavor. There we go. All right, enough already. potatoes, creamed cabbage, delicious cucumber, and really the best ever Danish meatballs. Enjoy. Oh, look at that texture. It's fine. We can focus on it. Smells good. Oh my god. It is juicy. It's fine. It's not coarse like the American meatball. Its consistency is spongy, happy. It reminds me, actually, of like a Chinese dim sum. When you have dim sum as steamed pork. This is delicious. I'm glad I went with the original recipe, and we can change it afterwards. But honestly, this is a perfect meatball. Absolutely nothing like the traditional heavy Italian meatballs. Enjoy it.